Yo, what's good, everybody? It's Nikhilis. I haven't done a sneaker review in a while. I've been busy wearing a bunch of Dames. As many of you guys know, Dame is my favorite player, so I haven't really had much interest in purchasing other shoes. But Nike recently came out with a new shoe, Nike Kyrie 6, that I was a huge fan of, just because they look like the Nike Yeezy 2, to be honest with you guys. This is the first shoe I have purchased in a while that isn't a Dame. So with that being said, let's dive into a sneaker review with this. All right, everybody, right here, we got the Nike Kyrie 6 box. Looks like it's inspired by some sort of Pac-Man theme that's going on. All across the box, you'll see his name and his logo in different sorts of colors. Nothing too crazy, but I do like the creativity. Here we have it, the Nike Kyrie 6, released November 22nd, 2019, at a price point of $130. In terms of the sizing, I personally went up half a size. However, I was wrong, and I should have went a whole size up. I normally wear a size 10. I got a size 10.5 for this shoe, but I should have gotten an 11. The Kyrie 6 has a super narrow toe box, making it uncomfortable for people who have wider feet. I say this because when I immediately put these on, I noticed my ring and pinky toe not having much wiggle room. Because of that, I say go a full size up. If you have wide feet, I definitely do not recommend this shoe. The traction and mobility on this shoe is above average, nothing great. I did these ladder drills to test how responsive and quick I was able to move. One thing I must give this shoe credit for is the incredible amount of balance I felt whenever I drove in and moved around the court. It must be a combination of the rounded edges and the traction pattern on the side of the shoe, making it easier to move around. I felt like I could have done Michael Jackson's anti-gravity lean in these shoes. For this shoe being $130, the comfort isn't great nor bad. I definitely have tried on more comfortable shoes, but I have no issue with the Zoom and the comfort of the Kyrie 6. The Kyrie 6 uses Air Zoom Turbo, which is the same technology used on the Kyrie 5. I definitely would say that the shoes are average when it comes to comfort. As mentioned, the shoe is narrow, so for my wide footers, go full size up. The lockdown and security may be my favorite part about this shoe. Although the mid strap doesn't tighten anything, the lacing system combined with the mid top makes you feel extra secure. I had no issue with the lockdown and actually felt like they did an incredible job with the Kyrie 6. Good job, Nike. The material on this shoe is actually pretty good in my opinion for a shoe that is retailing at $130. I've worn these shoes about 10 times already and no damages to the material have been made yet. I wanted to emphasize this because I recently saw Nightwing post a photo of his Dame 6s damaged already. And of course, if we're going to pay anything above $100, we do want to make sure the shoes last. Alright everybody, that basically wraps everything up with the Kyrie 6 performance review. Personally, I'd probably have to rate these shoes a solid 8, 8.5 out of 10. If you are on a budget and you're looking for an above average shoe, I'd personally recommend these. The traction, the comfort, the quality, all of them are not great, but neither are they average. It's above average. So I do think that the shoe is worth every penny. That being said, if you do have a little bit more money to spend, you're not on a budget, and you're looking for a shoe that specializes in traction, comfort, quality, whatever, I'd personally go ahead and find something else. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you guys think personally about the Kyrie 6s. If you guys have a shoe in mind that you guys want me to review, drop it down in the comment box below. In the meantime, see you guys soon. Peace.